So we're learning this method, this certain method of solving systems of equations. Quick review, what is a system of equations? Sean?
Multiple equations.
What's a solution to an equation? Just one equation. What's a solution to an equation like y equals 2x plus 5? What does it mean? You don't have to tell me what a solution or b solution is, but what does it mean to have a solution? What do you know you've got?
To have a point.
Not just any point. It's a special
point. Point on the line.
Okay. Well, to say a solution to the equation and a point on the line is saying the exact same thing. So what are we saying there? Johnny?
The equation is true.
When you do what?
When you have to grab it.
Put in a certain number.
Okay, not just one number.
Two.
Two numbers, right? Yeah, well, the point is a point, right? It's like a thing. It's like an object. The thing that you plug in are the values that you derive from the point, right? The point is in a place. Where that place is tells you what the x and y are. You plug in that x and y into the equation. If the equation is true, you have a solution, right? So, if we want to see a picture of all the solutions, what's that called?
Graph.
A graph. Right? The picture of all the solutions of these equations will be line-shaped. Right, line-shaped graphs. We've graphed a lot of these lines. So y-intercept of 5, slope of 2 over 1. Over 1 and up 2. Up 2 and over 1. And let's see, yeah, here it is, your line tool. There we go. Slope, right? It goes up 2 and over 1. This goes down to the left 1. Y-intercept of negative 1. Slope of 1 half. Means we're going to go up 1 and over 2. Okay. Draw a line back this way. Okay, so what are we looking for? Intersection, it looks like it's right here. Seems to be. I don't know if I drew my graph poorly, if they're actually supposed to intersect this strange intersection. Looks like either it should be something like negative 4, negative 3. Maybe it's supposed to be, you know, actually like negative 3 and a half, negative 2 and a half. Intersection's kind of weird. Make sure my graph is decent. This guy. There. This should be that. Graph, I'd say, to start with. Looks like it should be negative 4, negative 3. Right? Is that agreeable, Kaden?
Is that a point? The farthest one off the point that's farthest up.
This one? Yeah.
Is that a point?
Yeah.
Wouldn't it have to be like on a line?
On a line?
Yeah, on one of the lines because.
It looks like it's slightly off of this line?
But like on the graph line because.
That's the slope. The end of the slope.
I'll use the slope to find that point. The slope of up 2 over 1. So it looks like it should be negative 4, 3. Hopefully this is, I didn't plan it this way, but hopefully this is a pretty good commercial for graphing is not the best way to solve systems of equations. Especially when they both have positive or both have negative slopes, it can be difficult to find their intersection. But we can test this out. How can we test and see if we did find the right intersection point, the right solution? Plug it in, plug in negative 4 for x and negative 3 for y. So negative 3 for y. And negative 4 for x, equals negative 4 plus negative 8 plus 5. And negative 8 plus 5 is negative 3, so it checks out there. Negative 3 for y, 1 half times negative 4 minus 1. Negative 3 is negative 2 minus 1. Negative 2 minus 1 is negative 3, so check there too. Questions on that one? Okay. We had a rough time because even though it was just slightly off, this line, this top line here, I was just slightly off on it, I was slightly off on this line, and it was just enough to make that intersection kind of bad. It looked like it was on the halfway marks, but then we fixed it up a little bit. Not that it can't intersect somewhere in between these grid intersections, but hope it doesn't. Number 14, back over here. Y minus x is equal to 17. And y equals 4x plus 2. Before I even started graphing these, I would just take this guy, add x to both sides, and get y equals an x plus 17. That make sense? So now it's in slope-intercept form. Forget that. Just add x to both sides. And now I have this, and I got a slope of 1 over 1 there. Let's grab our... Alright, so this one right here we'll graph as a y-intercept of 2. Let's see if we can graph this better than last time. 4 and to the right 1. Right. That's our line. So this other one has a y-intercept of 17. I'm going to probably want to scale this down a bit. Not really meant that much. Right. And let's see. Ourselves for 9, 2, 6, 7, 6, 5. Let's see. 11, 12, 13, 14. 16, 17. So that positive slope, 1 over 1. So, any idea where those intersect?
Five and 20 something,
that sounds about right. Let's see, let's get a... like we have a ruler, so we can kind of.
6:20.
Measure up here. Looks like it's probably supposed to intersect at 5. And let's see, we get a horizontal line. Let's see where that might intersect. There. 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. This is awful. Okay, so 5, comma, maybe it's 22. I feel pretty confident about that 5. I don't know about that 22. Let's see. If I put a 5 there and multiply by 4, I get 20 plus 2. That's 22.
Yeah.
Okay, not bad. Put a 5 there plus 17. That's 22. Okay. Ooh, that's a rough one. You got it. So 5, 22. Any questions? What do you think about graphing? Graphing to find the solution of a system of equations? I don't really like it either. But we're going to do one more, okay? On the review. And then we'll find a better way. Okay? Because this way's not so hot. So let's get ready for that. Let's get the review, put everything away. Minus of the negative 7. Slope of 3 over 2, so you're over 2 at 3. R. Graph it. Green. No. Good job here. Tell me if you catch a mistake. Okay, y-intercept of 2. And a slope of negative 5/4, so we're going to go over 4 and down, let's see, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, oh, I did 2, over 2, down 5. Okay, we've got trouble with this one. That's gonna make sense. Can you graph it like this?
No, I do.
No.
I went down 4 and over
5. That was so awesome.
Well, even if we follow our slopes correctly, it's no match for me writing this problem incorrectly. So, if your graphs look like this, and I see you trying to figure out where that intersection is, that'll be enough for full credit here.
I did my opposite,
uh-huh.
So it's in the negatives.
Oh, so you got your positive slope. Positive slope is a
negative.
Negative 3,
negative
2. Negative 3. Okay. Well, this intersection is going to be something like 3.2, negative 2 point something, right? It's a little off. Because when I was writing the equations, I made an arithmetic error. Which I'll fix for the other class, but for that intersection. If I were to have done this the way I meant to do it, this would have been, let's see, this would have been a 9. No. So that would have been a 9. Let's see what that would look like if I had done that correctly. So this would be a 9, this would be a 7, this would come down 2 as well. And this much. And see how I counted the slope for the other one and how they land right there at the exact same place? That's what I was supposed to do. Okay. So as long as your graphs are correct, and I can tell you we're aiming for that intersection somehow, right, and try it over and over and over to plug in something and make it work, and that's fine. Because graphing is not a good solution, or a good way to find solutions if our solutions are fractions of decimals or whatever. Figure that out unless you were lucky it was like 0.5 or something like that. So if I had done it correctly, I had minus 9, then this intersection point would be where?
4, -3.
So we would try it out. We'd have 3/2 times 4 - 9. That'd be 3, and then we'd have to be equal to -3, right? So -3 equals 2, cancels with 4, loses 2. 3 times 2 is 6, -9. 6 minus 9 is -3. Do the other equation. -3 should be equal to -5/4 times 4 plus 2. -3 equals 4 is canceled. We get -5 plus 2. -5 plus 2 is equal to 7. All right, everybody okay? Are we permanently emotionally scarred out of that one?
Yeah.
All right, well, sorry for that one. But let's move on. Let's heal emotionally now. All right, do you remember where we left off last time, where I left you on this like cliffhanger and I asked you to agree to this statement? Does that ring a bell? Okay, let's review real quick what I said. So I gave you these two equations, right? And I said that we're going to try to find a solution to both of these equations, to this system of equations, right? And this is x, right? This x is black, and this x is black, so he says x is black to make what point? What point am I making there? The same. That x and that is the solution, right? This x and this x are the same. This y is red, this y is red, this y is red, right? Whatever this y is, the solution to the system, is the same y here and here. Okay? Agree so far? Okay. Now, I said another way that I can tell you what x and y are is I can just say x is this. I can say y is this. Okay? I would just be saying x is whatever that is right there, and y is whatever that is there. Agreed? And so, example here, y, whatever I write here, whether it be 12, -2, 15, anything, absolutely anything that I write there, if it's the right one, right, if it's true, then that should go there and there. We agreed there? Okay, so here is the thing. Here is the reveal. I'm going to write something there. We've all agreed that whatever it is, I should be able to put it right there. Okay? So the thing I'm going to write there is 2x minus 1.
Why?
Can anybody see why I wrote 2x minus 1 there?
Yes.
How do I know y is equal to 2x minus 1?
Okay. Because the one both so if the top y equals the lower y,
mm-hmm.
Then the top y must equal what the lower y is, which is 2x minus 1.
Exactly. The lower one is 2x minus 1. And so this one must also be equal to whatever the x is times 2, subtract 1 from it. That's exactly what this y should be equal to. Right?
Yes.
Same x, same y. Huh?
And you could also do the same with the other one if you put it in.
Yeah, I could subtract 2x. Right?
From both sides.
Okay. Yeah, if you get -2x plus 3, y equals -2x plus 3.
Yeah.
Could do the same thing. Right? Because they're equal, they're the same thing. They're both the same y, the same x. Right? So hopefully this approach has made it so you get y. I'm about to plug 2x minus 1 in right there. Okay? Because they're the same x and the same y. And if I can make an equivalence between y and x, then I can just go ahead and replace y with that information.
No, x1.
Well, let's see. 2x, right? 2x, I'm just bringing that part down, plus, right, I'm going to replace y with this stuff. 2x minus 1, right? I just replace y with 2x minus 1 equals 3. And I mean, I could distribute a 1 in there, but nothing would really change. Everything would just be the same. So 2x plus 2x minus 1 equals 3. 4x minus 1 equals 3. Add 1 to both sides. So I know x is 1, so I have half of the solution. How do I find the other half?
Plug in x.
There's an equation that will give me y. If I give it x, I'll give it x, and it'll give me y. 2 times 1, minus 1, y equals 2 times 1 is 2, minus 1 is also 1. Does that mean the solution to every system is 1, 1?
No.
Does that mean that x and y are the same? So we're just looking at the coincidence here. Okay. Feels like they like at least 50% understand the idea here. It's called substitution. 50% understand substitution. Okay, we're doing pretty good. Let's do another one. Okay, substitution is where I just get one equation to tell me y equals this, or x even, x equals this. I could get it to do that. Either equation, either x or y, and then we substitute into the other equation. Okay? That's the whole idea. If you grasp it, you got it. That's all we're trying to learn here today. So a simple substitution. Let's do one where, well, I won't tell you what the difference is here. I'm going to do this one together again, and then give you a crack. So in practice, like actually doing it, it's not that difficult. Understanding why we're doing it, that's more important. So again, what we're looking for is an x and a y. The x is the same here and here. The y is the same here and here. Whatever this x is, that's what this x has to be. Whatever this x has to be the same thing. And this x is 2y plus 7. So this x should be... So 3 times the new x expression is 2y plus 7. Okay. So 3 times x minus 2y, that's the next part of the equation, equals 3. Okay. Now I'll leave it to you to figure out what y is. Go ahead and figure out what y is. Okay, so what are we going to do first to solve this system of equations? Y with x plus 7, because y is x plus 7. Very good. 2x equals x plus 7 minus 10. 2x equals x minus 3. We'll subtract x from both sides. X is equal to negative 3. X is negative 3. Then we'll use that in this equation, right? Negative 3 plus 7. 7 equals y. Negative 3. That's what y is. So our solution, negative 3, 4. Make sure you always finish up the problem here by giving the full final answer of this is x and this is y. Okay, and it would be easiest to just write an ordered pair, negative 3, comma. Like not set up exactly the way you'd like. You just have to make it that way. Or you can do substitution. Like, what's this system missing? How am I supposed to solve this? Josie?
You have to get either x or y by itself.
Good. And it's up to you, like, which equation you use, whether you solve for x or solve for y. Which one do you see would be the easiest one to solve for? Josie?
Solving for x.
In which equation?
In the first one.
In the first one. If you just subtract 4y from both sides, right? So x equals negative 4y plus 14. Now we know what x can be equal to, and we replace this x with that. 3 times negative 4y plus 14 plus 7y equals 22. I'll leave it to you to solve for y, and then figure out what x is, okay? But that's the only other real thing, is sometimes you're going to need to pick an equation, solve for x or y, and just choose one that's easiest to solve for.